to first start with a fully functional landing zone and show you the components of a fully functional landing zone. So going back to the basics video, we already spoke about many of these things, but now I will explain the same in the context of all these components. So first, let's start with AI Studio interface. Secondly, the hub. And thirdly, the project. So as you can see from here, you have AI Studio, AI project, which AI Studio signifies the interface itself and the hub, and AI project signifies the AI project here. Also, you will see here the a storage, a search, a key vault, container registry, and other Azure AI sources attached to the hub. So, and those components are key vault. You can see the storage account. You can see the container registry. You can see the Azure OpenAI service itself, and other AI services in the form of speech, language, and any other vision APIs that you might need access to. So in addition to this, this itself, virtual network you see here is this virtual network. So this virtual network could further be used to connect to other landing zones or to connect to your enterprise, etc. So within this, currently there is only one subnet I have created, and the network security group corresponding to that particular VNet is also available. In addition to that, you will be seeing a bunch of private endpoints. So these private endpoints, in my case, I have secured Azure OpenAI within a virtual network. And therefore, you know, like I need a managed outbound to that from my managed VNet. And also I secured my AI hub so that only outbound traffic is allowed. And, you know, it really doesn't, you know, like allow any inbound traffic from public sources. So when we talk about managed virtual network, we talk in the context of managed outbound, which is, you know, like communicating outside of the managed network. And therefore, you know, like since the only service in my example, which is a OpenAI service that is secured within this network, it needs managed outbound. And since I allowed outbound access to the internet, not many companies will have problem. Again, like I mentioned yesterday, if you don't need to, you can simply say, you know, like I don't allow any outbound traffic, in which case you need to run the managed firewalls. However, if you choose, you know, to allow outbound internet, you know, which is a case, I necessarily don't need these managed firewalls in order for me to reach, let's say, Conda packages or GitHub or anything like that. So with that said, there is one more concept, which is, you know, like AI Studio interface itself could be blocked from the internet. I did not do this in this example, but if you choose to do, I will show you in a second where that is, but if you choose to do so, then you have to integrate that within your virtual network, and therefore you need to establish a private link connection to that virtual network, and you need a managed endpoint in order to do that. And also, as you can see here, if you have to use, let's say, notebooks and machine learning, then you know you need this connectivity, right, to AI Studio interface, which is really outside of that managed network, and therefore, you know, probably you will be seeing some of you know, like the private link connections such as api.azureml.ems and private link.notebooks.azure.net, so that you know you can freely use the notebooks as well as other machine learning components that are available within your AI project and our hub. And this enables the AI Studio service itself, which comprises of the interface, which is ai.azure.com and the AI Hub. So this public access, there are three tabs here. The first tab, public access, is for this interface. If you set it to disabled, it is equal to that. If you set it enabled to all networks, so that means, you know, you can go to ai.azure.com and choose your hub. So that's what that means. So either way is acceptable, depends on the organization. So just remember that. So that is for that. Then coming to the second one. So these private endpoint connections, the private endpoint connections are the connections between, for example, you know, you can think of them as inbound. If, for example, let's say this AI Studio is secured within the virtual network, and this if I say, you know, like I disable the public access, you need to make sure you actually integrate it with your virtual network, thereby establishing, you know, like a private endpoint connection to your virtual network. And that's where this section comes into picture. Don't worry about all of these things. I have been playing with this for some time now. But don't worry about it. So these are nothing but, you know, if you secured your interface called AI Studio and say internet access disabled, then it really doesn't know, you know, how the traffic needs to be traversed to it, right? Except through your VNet. And that's where these private endpoint connections come into the picture. On the other facet, so what about this managed VNet that I have shown here? That managed VNet is this managed outbound access. Whenever we speak about managed VNet, we talk about managed VNet's outbound access, like really what are these greenish red arrows that are coming out. And they could be a managed firewall, or they could be a managed outbound endpoint from this, right? If your service is secured, then, you know, obviously you need a managed outbound. And also, you know, like if your AI Studio itself is secured into the virtual network, you really need to know, right, what this workspace is, or the traffic that is originating from the managed VNet, where from it is coming. You need to know what is this arrow, right? So that also corresponds to this. So let's see actually what is available in this section. You have three different kinds of managed outbound access. For example, you can disable that. So that means there's no managed VNet, which means whatever is there within the boundary of the Azure AI workspace, it could be accessed, right? Example, a computer, you know, like the outbound data movement is unrestricted. That's what it means. And when you select allow internet outbound, your private resources are secured, which means, for example, in this case, my Azure OpenAI service is a secured service, right? And therefore, I need this managed outbound endpoint in order to connect my OpenAI. Otherwise, it doesn't know what it is, right? Because this is not an internet. So therefore, you know, just outbound access, allow internet outbound, doesn't mean anything except, you know, it doesn't know what that is. And therefore, you need to establish a managed outbound. So let's say you go ahead and say allow only approved outbound. Let me select that. Just I want to show to you. So Microsoft provides this bunch of rules for you, right? In which case, if you were to select this, we don't want you to spin each and every outbound rule, whether it's a private point or service tag, by yourself. Rather, we automated everything, which is really good. You know, like when you spin up your first compute or whatever in your project and our AI studio, most of these will be activated, right? So it'll take some time to activate, but they will be activated. And also, you can define your own user-defined outbound rules, in which case, you know, this is exactly what I have been talking about, right? So for example, instead of choosing either a private endpoint or a service tag, you can choose fully qualified domain name. And this fully qualified domain name could be the URL of a Conda package or Conda environment that you are interested in, or it could be any fully qualified domain name URL, and we create every rule you create here is nothing but a firewall rule, right? So this is that firewall. So the managed firewall that I have shown here is signified by this FQTN. But apart from that, you can actually, you know, like just if you want to do it, no internet connectivity, only managed outbound connectivity to our Azure resources, right? Such as key vaults and container registries, and you know, probably the GitHub links, and you know, the Conda package links would go through FQDN, and you are taken care of. So these are the three different rules that are available. So in summary, what you have seen thus far is you have created an AI studio. In my case, let me come out of this. So I have created my AI studio with the public access enabled for my studio URL itself, which is ai.azure.com. And then, you know, I need private endpoint connections if and only if my studio interface itself is secured. When I choose disabled here, then I go to the private endpoints, and then I will establish a connection to the virtual network, and thereby enabling this connectivity. And when we speak about managed outbound access, the managed outbound access is in the context of outbound traffic to the secured services. And if you choose not to enable the internet access, then you need to create not only the automated rules, but also some of the fully qualified domain rules for Conda packages, GitHub, etc. So these are the bare minimum basics of how you will be creating a fully functional environment. And I will show you the Terraform template in a second and walk you through some of the items in there. But basics wise, that's all you need to know, right? Whatever I showed in the interface and whatever we spoke about basics here, they are automated in the Terraform template. You can use ARM or Bicep, it's your choice. But I chose to use Terraform, and within Terraform I chose to use is the API of Terraform. Thank you. Part of this video, now let me go ahead and show the Terraform template. Like I said, at the time of this recording, there is no way I could have used the inbuilt Terraform module for machine learning workspace. Therefore, I used AZ API resource. There is a greater deal of documentation which I will be copy pasting underneath the video, as well as I will be actually checking this code into the GitHub, and I will provide you the GitHub link. So just pay attention on, you know, like the details, and you get this code, don't worry about it. So AI, like a machine learning, is a workspace, and but this is a specialized workspace called AI workspace. So within AZ API resource, as you can see, this is of type Microsoft.machineLearningService, and this is workspace, and the API I'm using is a very latest API, as you have seen, right? So and hopefully new APIs will come, and you know, this will be changing. So if you see, right, so what did I do? I actually, you know, like have created an AI project. There are two things we need to create, right? AI Studio Hub and AI project. So I have created both of these, and also a bunch of connections, right? So first, let's start with AI Studio or Hub, what we call, right? And it comes with the interface, you know this. So the basic difference between a project and the AI Studio, if you see, both of them are the machine learning workspaces, okay? And then you can enable a system assigned managed identity on that. And also, if you see, you know, some of the details, so this is of type hub, right? And if it is a project, that's of the type project, right? Leave the SKU names, they are default. And within the project, I'm associating a keyword, a container registry, an application insights environment. And also, I showed you the three different, tabs within the network of hub, right? In that, when you go to the manage network tab, that is equal to this, you saw the isolation out mode of allow internet outbound, right? So one is disabled, and second one is allow internet outbound, and the third one is allow selected outbound, right? So which is more restrictive than others. And you know, since my OpenAI itself is secured, I am actually creating, you know, like for example, here, you know, like an OpenAI private endpoint that goes along with this managed network, right? That way, you know, like if your storage is secured, if your other key vault is secured, you probably need to do the exact same thing for all of those stuff. And for hub itself, I have enabled the public network access, and if you disable the public network access here, then all you need to do is you need to actually create private endpoint connections to your VNet, which we spoke about when I was showing a little time ago. And you know, you associated pretty much, you know, like your storage account, and also you have to say legacy mode is false, because the legacy mode is true, then you are really referring to the old machine learning workspaces, right? Which is still, by the way, appropriate and functional for pure machine learning work. But if you are doing AI work, then you know, you have to choose that as false. So I have created, you know, container registry, key vault, log analytics. You already know this. These are the regular Terraform, Azure RM resources. And I'm not going to go into this, but let's go through the AZ API AI project. So if you go through the AI project, pretty much it is same, but instead of hub, you are choosing project here, and you can provide a friendly name instead of a number. And also, you know, like remaining pieces, you know, like leave them by default, right? Because let it inherit from the hub. And also, the third important aspect is we have seen a bunch of connections, right? So you have to establish a OpenAI connection from your hub, which is also by the AZ API resource. So these things will be changing now. This UI is a little bit under, this Terraform Azure API resource is a little bit unstable now. Sometimes when you spin, it just says, you know, like, it's a older connection upgrade or something. I need to do a little bit more research on that, because, you know, this was a preview API, and hopefully now, you know, it's no more a preview API. I need to revisit this and a little bit correct it. Use it. If this doesn't work out, please make sure you switch this to a stable non-preview API if that API comes. Same, you are actually, you know, like doing a cognitive search connection, and you know, you can create an Azure machine learning compute instance, and these are the cognitive services, right? The video, speech, text analytics, and the regular cognitive services that you know for all of these days. So this is pretty much new for most of you, because you would not have seen all of these AZ API resources. That's why I want to go through them in detail. But you already know this is a well-established service. This is the vector database or AI search database, we call it. And also, you know, like this is regular same private endpoint connections. You know, like if you were to secure your hub, you know, like you create bunch of private endpoint connections which you will define in the variables.tf file, and also the network itself, right? So I have created a vnet and a subnet and all of that stuff. So this is simple and straightforward. And also, you know, like Azure RM cognitive account of type OpenAI. This is the first party Terraform resource. You don't need to use AC API for this. And if you actually create this, and if you want to actually, you know, like disable the public access, you can do so. So this is just simple, straightforward stuff, right? So yeah, so that's about it. So pretty much, you know, I have created all the ensemble that you saw a little while back in the portal using the same Terraform, which I'll provide you the links for. In this, most of the stuff, you know, but you know, the only additional thing is in AI.tf, and this is the diagnostic settings you can set up, right, in order to actually get the telemetry from all of these resources. So this is the landing zone. This is how you would be creating a typical AI landing zone. And you know, this is very new, right? So these AI services keep changing, like, you know, like every fortnight or so, for the sure. So as a best practice, I would caution you to you know, check the preview APIs used in this, and make sure you actually change those APIs as needed, and also keep an eye on the Terraform modules. I would like you not to use AZ API, but you use the first party Azure RM Terraform module once they are available. And I will also change and do, let's say, one more video at the time. But I do think this is an excellent start for everyone. There's not much material in there for this. But please stick with Microsoft documentation on AI in general, and AI Studio, AI Project. They're very good at maintaining that documentation, and that is where, you know, you or I will see the change that occurs. So with that said, I hope you enjoyed these two videos that I published on AI Landing Zone. I really, really appreciate you sending some feedback, and also, you know, like if I missed anything, just correct me. I would be gladly changing anything. Yeah, with that said, thanks a lot. I will see you all very soon, and enjoy your July 4th long weekend. Bye.